It's possible to see tardigrades with the naked human eye, so humans may have been aware of them prior to this. However, tardigrades were first scientifically described in 1773 by zoologist and pastor
Johann August Ephraim Goes.
He called them
Kleiner Wasserbär,
which means little water bear, and they've since gained other common names, such as moss piglets.
The name tardigrade, which was applied to the animals a few years later, means slow stepper or slow paced. Within 3 years of their initial scientific description,
Lazzaro Spallanzani
learned tardigrades are bilaterally symmetrical and segmented with a head and four leg-bearing body parts.
The presence of their segments has tardigrades placed in a proposed group including velvet worms and arthropods, called Panarthropoda. This proposed group forms a clade, which indicates all the animals within it have a common ancestor. Tardigrades are not arthropods, although they're believed to be closely related to them.
Apart from their head, each of a tardigrade's segments hosts a pair of legs, and each of these legs have at least four little claws at the end. While they may give off menacing vibes, a tardigrade's claws help it hold on tight to vegetation in the water, so they can live in fast-flowing waterways, although they live in almost every wet habitat on Earth.
Like many amphibians, tardigrades are considered aquatic animals. They require moisture in their environment to ensure they don't dry out, at least not by accident. Tardigrades are fully capable of handling environmental stressors, such as drought, through a process known as cryptobiosis. In this dried-out phase, a tardigrade is called a tun.
Cryptobiosis is a process involving a complete shutdown of metabolic processes in the body, or otherwise the transformation of food into energy. This is fully reversible once conditions have improved. So, even though they enter a death-like state, tardigrades can wake back up completely alive when environmental stress is alleviated.
Although tardigrades are capable of withstanding extreme environmental stressors through cryptobiosis, they're not considered extremophiles, because they cannot live in these conditions. At the end of the day, tardigrades need water to live, and their extreme survival has limitations, including perpetual heat or cold.
There isn't one single tardigrade species. There are hundreds of them. In marine habitats alone, there are around 150 described tardigrade species, and more than quadruple that in freshwater habitats. As of this recording, there are over 1,000 living tardigrade species.
Tardigrades have shown up in plenty of media, including TV shows such as Futurama and South Park. One example of a tardigrade character in a show is Tad Mulholland from Kipo and the Age of Wonder Beasts. He's a tardigrade made up of a community of tardigrades.
Another tardigrade character from TV is Ripper from Star Trek Discovery. Originally, the character was to be named after the zoologist who discovered tardigrades and even remain on the show as a Starfleet member. Unfortunately, this proved to be too expensive, so the character was scrapped, but Ripper still made an appearance in the show.
Did you also know that tardigrades have actually been to space? Check out our full tardigrade episode to learn even more. There's a card on screen you can click right now. Go ahead, click it. There's lots to learn. And thanks for watching Animal Fact Files.